So here from this video, I will explain how to do past perfect question on labor hosting. So I will discuss from 2012 to 2018 A level, but in 2015 paper, they have not given any labor hosting question. Question number 4, B part. Atula, Kamal and Eranda are three employees of a company. The following information is given in relation to their salaries for the month of March 2012. But in the Roman number 1, they have given hours worked. Remember, when it comes to weekdays, Atula, Kamal, Eranda, they have all worked for 40 hours. Usually, when a person works in a company or an organization, they have to work for 8 hours per day. So 8 into 5 days, 40 hours. So this Roman number 1, they have given for weekdays for a week, even weekends for a week. So when you are calculating the basic salary, multiplied by 4, because here we are making the pay sheet for the month. Roman number 2, hourly rates, rate for weekdays, 200 per hour. Overtime rates for the weekend, 1.5 times of the weekday rate. Number 3, employees' provident fund contribution by employer and employee are 15% and 10% respectively. ETF contribution by the employer is 3%. Overtime payments are not considered in calculating EPF and ETF. That means when you're calculating EPF and ETF, you have to get it from the basic salary. That's what they say. Number 4, deductions. Employee contribution to the welfare society per month, 200 per employee. Monthly loan installment of around the 4,000. The first requirement is pay sheet. Here the columns are names, earnings. Under that, you get the basic salary and OT. When you added up these two, it's called the gross salary. According to this question, there are 3 deductions. EPF contribution made by the employee, welfare society, and the loan installment. Then there's another column to get the total deductions. Gross salary minus total deduction, you get the net salary. Then employer contribution, EPF and ETF, these are the columns. So under name, we are writing Atula, Kamal, Eranda. Basic salary for all 3 employees, 40 per week. So when you multiply it by 4, they have worked for 160 hours. 160 into 200, that is the rate. 32,000 is the basic salary for each and every employee. Then when it comes to overtime, Atula on the weekend is the dash. So he has not done any overtime. Kamal, 10, that is per week. So there are 4 weeks. Altogether, he has worked 40 hours extra. They have given the rate 1.5 times of the weekday rate. 1.5 means the rate, weekday rate is 200. 200 and another half. Half is 100. So the amount is 300. 40 into 300, he's getting 12,000 as the OT amount. Eranda, he has worked for 20 hours per week. So it multiplied by 4 to get the monthly hours, 80 into 300, 24,000. Basic plus overtime is your gross salary. The EPF and ETF, they ask us to get it from the basic salary. 32,000 into 10% is 3,200. 32,000 into 15%, 4,800 each. 32,000 into 3%, 960 each. Deductions, employee contribution to the welfare from each employee 200, we have deducted, and monthly loan installment of around the 4,000. So here there's a column for the total deduction, 3,200 and 200, 3,400, 3,200 plus 200, 3,400, like that, get the addition. Then 32,000 minus 3,400, the net salary is 28,600. 44,000 minus 3,400 is 40,600. 56,000 minus 7,400 is 48,600. Then when you are simplifying the pay sheet, we are having a double line from gross salary to ETF column. So we are adding up vertically. And the second requirement is salaries control account, EPF payable account, ETF payable account for the month of March. So there are double entries we have to remember. I have already uploaded a video on labor costing. Y'all can go through it. So here, when we are starting with the gross salary, the double entry for gross salary is wages and salaries account debit, wages and salary control account credit. So salaries control account credit. The second double entry is for all deductions. So when you deduct all these entries, control account debit, salaries control account debit, and relevant expense, relevant account credit. Control account debit 9,600 as EPF payable. EPF payable account credit as wages and salary control 9,600. Then welfare 600, we don't want to open up a T account for the welfare, and the loan installment 4,000. So when you simplify this account, you will get the net salary amount that we have to write as cash. So when the company pays salary out of their cash, cash credit, control account debit. Then EPF contribution made by the employer, the double entry is EPF expense debit, EPF payable credit. ETF double entry is ETF expense debit, ETF payable account credit. So ultimately, control account will be balanced. EPF payable get the carried down brought forward. ETF payable also get the carried down brought forward. Third requirement, employees related total expenses. So that is the addition of gross salary, EPF expense, and ETF expense. Employee related total expenses means the amount that we have to put it under administration expenses, because those are expenses related to employees. So gross salary, EPF expense, and ETF expense. The answer is 149 to 80. Question number 5A part. The following information has been extracted from the payroll of Abdul PLC for the months of March and February. So in the question, they have given March and February, basic salary, overtime, employee provident fund, employee portion, and employer, ETF, deduction, membership fee to the trade union, and recovery of staff loan. Additional information, number one, every month's salary is paid on the 10th day of the following month. Number two, every month EPF and ETF contributions are remitted on the 15th day of the following month. Requirement number one, employee related expenses. So that is the addition of gross salary, EPF expense and ETF expense. Here they are asking for the month of March. So when you're looking at the March column, the basic salary is 8,000, overtime is 500, altogether your gross salary is 8,500. And employer contribution for the EPF for the month of March is 1,200, that goes to your EPF expense, and ETF 240. So the total amount is 9,940. Requirement number two, salaries control account, salaries payable account, and EPF payable account of the company for the month of March 2013, including the opening balances. Now here they have given additional information. Every month salary is paid on the 10th day of the following month. So February month salary, they are paying in March. Just like the same way EPF and ETF also, February month EPF, ETF, they are going to remit in March. They have already remitted in March. So that is what you mean by the opening balances. Now, when it comes to salary payable, there's a BEF to the credit side. That is a February month salary, net salary. 7,400 is the addition of basic and OT minus employee contribution 700. And there are two more deductions, 150 and 200. I will tell it again. 7,400. Now, this is the February month information. Basic salary 7,000 plus OT, that is 7,400. Minus, there are three deductions. One is employee contribution of 700. Then the membership fee to the trade union, 150. And recovery of staff loan, 200. All are deductions. So when you take this one, your net salary in the month of February was 6,350. That's the opening balance. So when you are starting the month of March, that was a payable amount. Just like the same way EPF payable, employee and employer contributions were accrued, payable. So in the February month, EPF employee 700, employer 1,050. Altogether 1,750 on the credit side BEF. So that amount they are paying in March. So what's the double entry? Cash credit, salary payable, debit. That amount they are paying in March. EPF payable in the 15th day of the following month they have paid. That means in March they have paid it. Cash credit, EPF payable account, debit. After entering these two, now think that you are in March. Now go through one by one. Starting with the gross salary. Gross salary is 8,500. The double entry is wages and salary account debit, control account credit. So here we are opening only the control. So control account credit 8,500 and wages and salaries. Then there are three deductions, EPF, employee, trade union amount, and the loan amount. Control account debit, relevant account credit. EPF payable, March 800. EPF payable account credit, 800 as salaries control. Then trade union amount, 250, and the staff loan, 450. Ultimately, when you balance this, that 7,000 is not cash entry because they have said you are making the payment in the next month. Until that, we have to transfer these 7,000 to salaries payable account. So salary payable account credits 7,000 as salaries control. Then ultimately, when you balance this, you get a carried down brought forward, that is for the month of April. When you are starting the month of April, again, there's a balance of 7,000. EPF payable, employer contribution is 1,200 for the month of March. So the double entry is EPF expense debit, EPF payable credit. When you simplify, only this month value, you will get carried down brought forward. 1,200 plus 800 because the last month amount you have already settled it. A-level, question number 4A part. The salary-related information of Northern Tire Manufacturers PLC for the month of March 2014. Description, they have given employee category, production workers, production supervisors, production manager, administrative assistants. Additional information, the incentive payment relates to completion of an order to manufacture a special category of tires required the following for the month ending 31st 3 2014. Direct wages means the people who are directly involved with the production process. So out of these four categories, there are production workers. Number two, employee related expenses included in production overheads. So under production overheads, when it comes to the four categories, we are taking production supervisor and production manager entry. Number three, they are asking employee related total expenses, that is the total value. That is addition of all employee categories. So here, basic salary. Now this is the requirement number one, number two, and number three. Basic salary for the production worker, 5,000. Incentive payment, 2,500. Bonus is based on the company profit. Then the deductions are done by the production worker's salary, so it won't come here. Then employer contribution, that is a company contribution, EPF 750 and ETF 150. The addition of direct wages, 8,400. Employee related expenses, production overhead, that is the addition of production supervisors and production managers. Basic salary, 3,000 plus 1,005 is 4,500. Overtime, 500 plus 250 is 750. Traveling allowance, 250 and 150, 400. Then company contribution, EPF, addition 450 plus 225, 675. ETF 90 plus 45, 135. Addition is 6,460. Employee related total expenses, that the addition of all four categories. So basic salary addition is 5,000, 3,000, 1,005, and 500. Altogether the value is 10,000. Incentive payment 2,500. Overtime amount, 750, traveling, 400, bonus, 500, based on company profit. So that is the total expense related to employees. then employer contribution or the company contribution for EPF, the total is 1,500, ETF 300. The addition is 15,950. A level 15 in the question paper, there's no labor costing question. So 2016 A level question number 6 A part. Migara Educational Institute established on 1/3/2016 conduct English diploma programs for school leavers. It employs 2 permanent teachers and a temporary teacher. Each teacher has to teach 120 hours per month. Roman number 1, the gross salary of teachers consists of the following items. Payment for teaching, that is for 120 hours. Permanent for teacher, 75,000 per month. Temporary, 500 per hour. Payments for conducting extra sessions, that is like overtime, 750 per hour. Marking of answer script, 100 per paper. Number of teaching hours and answer script marked for the month of March 2016. In that, they have given the 2 permanent teachers are Nandini and Suresh. Manjula is a temporary teacher. So here, hours they have to work 120. So when you take the basic salary, Nandini and Suresh, the amounts are 75,000 because they are permanent teachers. When it comes to Manjula, 120 hours is a standard into 500 rupees, that is a basic salary. Extra sessions. So when you're looking at that question, hours worked during the month, Nandini has worked for 140 hours, but standard hours 120, she has worked 20 hours more. So for that 20, they are paying 750 per hour. So the amount is 15,000 when it comes to Suresh. Standard hours 120, but he has worked for 160 hours. Extra 40 hours into 750, you get 30,000. When it comes to Manjula, she has worked for 180 hours. So that is 60 hours more into 750. That is 45,000. So if they have marked answer script, they are paying 100 per paper. Number of answer script marked, Nandini 100, 100 into 100 rupees, 10,000. Suresh 150 papers into 100, 15,000. Manjula 200 papers into 100, 20,000. So when you added up everything, that's your gross salary. The contribution to the EPF and ETF are based on the gross salary of both permanent and temporary teachers. So since they have given that statement, we have to get it from the gross salary. EPF employer contribution is 15%. So 100,000 into 15%, 100,000 into 10%, and 100,000 into 3%. So 100,000 minus 10,000, net salary for Nandini 90,000. 120 minus 12,000, 108,000. 125 minus 12,500, 112,500. Number 2, salaries control account, only they are asking. So the gross salary double entry is salaries, wages and salaries account, debit control account, credit. Control account credit 345,000. That's the addition of gross salary. Then there's one deduction here, EPF contribution made by the employee, 34,500, EPF payable account, credit control account, debit. So the net salary we are writing as cash, 310,500. A-level question number 4A part. In this question, the requirement, the following accounts for the month of July, wages, wages control, EPF expense, and EPF payable. But as a working, I have made a pay sheet, then it's easy to post it. So here, when you go through this question, the gross wages for the month was 680, which consisted of the following. So here they have given you the gross salary, 680, but read it first. Basic wages for 4,800 normal hours worked at 100 per hour. So the basic salary is 4,800 hours at the rate of 4 time premium for 500 hours worked at hourly rate of 150. So 500 at a rate of 150, the OT amount is 75,000. A bonus of 100,000 on profit basis. So that will add it up to the gross salary, 100,000. When it comes to gross salary, they have given you the total is 680. But when you're looking at the fourth Roman number, number four, labor charges of 25,000 paid to an outside party for installation of a machine. It is also included here. That 25,000, you can't put it in the pay sheet. So ultimately, your gross salary is 655. That is the addition of basic OT and bonus. Deductions from the wages for the month is contribution to EPF, 48,000. Those are deductions. Loan installment, 120,000. Contribution to welfare fund, 25,000. So 655 minus everything, you get the net salary, 462,000. The employer and employee contribution to EPF are 15 and 10% respectively. They have given already 48,000. That is 418 to 10%. So 418 to 15% is the employer contribution. By using these information, we are going to prepare accounts. Wages account debit 655,000 as wages control. Wages control account credit 655 as wages. Then control account debit all deductions, which is EPF payable 48,000. EPF payable account credit 48,000 as control. Loan installment 120,000 and welfare 25,000. The net salary we are taking as cash. That's the amount actually you are paying. Then the employer contribution is 72. EPF expense debit 72,000 as EPF payable. EPF payable account credit 72,000 as EPF expense. So payable account, we are balancing, get the carried down brought forward. EPF expense transfer to the profit or loss. Wages transfer to the profit or loss. A-level. Question number 4. So here, the first requirement is a payroll. Number 2, employee-related expenses. Number 3, purchase journal and cash payment journal. And following assets and liability balances as at 31st 3, 2018. Now, when you go through from top to bottom, They have given transactions with Northern Publishers, purchase of books on credit, 550,000, that goes to your purchase journal. So the invoice number they have given, Northern Publishers, 550,000. Return of books that did not match the specification, 50,000. That goes to your trade payable account. Trade payable account, debit side, purchase return, 50,000. Cash payment subjected to 5% cash discount. So 550 minus 50 is 500,000. They have said 475,000 is the amount you have paid. So Northern, the value is 475. Discount received is 25,000. That's the difference between 500,000 and 475. The creditor column, we had to put 475. Purchase of books on cash, 100,000. So when you are taking the purchases, that is the cash purchases plus credit purchases. So here, Northern's portion is here. Out of these 250 cash purchases, 100 is purchases on cash from Northern. The other 150, you got it from Salmonella Publishers on cash. That is how you got 250. Then they have given you transactions with Salmonella Publishers, purchase of books on credit. The list price is 410. Under that, they have given you trade discount 10%. Sorry, 10,000. So the value is 400,000. Value is 400,000. When you added up these two, that is your credit purchase value. What's the double entry? Purchasers debit, creditor control credit. Purchasers debit, you have to add it to purchasers 950 and creditor control credit 950 as purchasers. Then they have given you sales with 20% profit margin on selling price, cash sales 800,000, credit sales 500. Altogether, your sales amount is 1,300,000. So the credit sales amount is 500,000. The double entry is sales credit, debtor account debit, 500,000. Cash received from debtors, cash debit, debtor account credit, 420. Salaries paid to employees, salaries paid to employees, that's a net salary. So when you pay to employees, purchases on cash from Northern, 100,000, purchases 100. Cash paid to Salmonella, you have to put it into the payment journal, 300,000, creditor 300. And cash purchases from Salmonella, 150. It goes to your cash payment journal. The total salaries you have paid for employees, Jinadas, Siripala, and Sugat, altogether addition is 135,000. That goes to expense column as well. Then rent paid 72,000 under expense 72,000. By using these salaries paid to employees, we have to make the pay sheet. That is the net salary value they have given. Salary is paid. That's a net salary. 63,000 for Jinadasa, 45,000 for Siripala, and Sugat, 27,000. So here they have paid to Jinadasa 63, Siripala 45,000, and Sugat 27,000. Additional information number one, salaries of all employees for March 2018 have been paid after deducting the following. So here, when you take this entry, contribution to EPF, 8% of gross salary, employee welfare fund, monthly contribution, 2% of gross salary. So remember always, percentage represent 100, gross salary always 100. From that, they have deducted 8 as the EPF, and EWF, they have deducted 2. Altogether, from 100, they have deducted 10. So your net salary amount is 90. So to calculate the gross salary, 63,000 is for 90. What's the value for 100? That is Jinadas's gross salary. For the other, Siripala and Subhat also, you can get the amounts like that. So 63,000 is the net salary. If this net salary is 90, what's the value for 100? 45,000 is for 90. When you multiply it by 100, you get 50,000. 27,000 divided by 90 multiplied by 100, the value is 30. So from this 8%, you get the EPF contribution made by the employee. Gross salary into 2%, that is the employee welfare contribution. The company contributes 12% and 3%, that's the employer contribution. From the gross salary, again, 70,000 into 12% and 3%. The company remits cash to EPF, ETF, and EWF of each month on the 10th day of the following month. Carrying amounts of assets and liabilities as at 1/3/2018, that's the opening balance. Inventory, 150,000, that's opening stock, 150. Trade payables, BF to the credit, 120. Trade receivable, BF debit, 180. EPF payable, that is the last month EPF payable, 30,000. This is EPF payable account, BF to the credit, 30. That 30 you are paying in this month. You are paying in this month. That is why cash payment account credit as EPF 30,000. The last month amount you are paying in this month. So that goes to your other column. ETF payable. At the beginning, 4,500. That is the last month ETF. So you are paying in this month. Into the cash payment journal, ETF 4,500, other column 4,005. At the same time, EWF 3,000 at the beginning, that amount we have paid in March. 3,000. The bookstore is maintained in a rented building and the rent paid relates to a 6-month period commencing on 1/3/2018. This rent amount, 72,000, you have paid for 6 months. But we had to calculate only for 1 month. So this is your pay sheet. Number two, they're asking how much the total expenses related to employees. That is, gross salary addition is 150,000. Employer contribution for EPF 18,000 and ETF 4,500. This is the purchase journal. This is the payment journal. Then when it comes to the closing balances, now they're asking the closing stock amount from you. Opening stock, we got it 150,000. Purchases, cash and credit, 1,200. Purchase return, 50,000. Gross profit, we don't know yet, but the sales amount is 1,300,000. In there, they have said with 20% profit margin on selling price. From the sales, the profit is 20%. 1,300. From that, 20% is the profit. Then the cost of sale is the remaining amount. So when you go from top to bottom, 150 plus 1200 minus 50, here the value is 1300. The difference between these two is a closing stock balance, 260. When you balance your trade receivable, you get a carried down brought forward. That is a second entry. Third one, when you simplify everything, you get the trade payables account. So this cash payment, you can see Northern Publishers, we have paid 475, and to Salmonella, 300,000. Altogether, it's 775. Discount received is 25. Purchase return 50. When you balance it, your trade payable account balance is 225. Other payables, BF amount, last month we have put it as payable BF, already paid in this month. This is 12 and 18, this month values. EPF, employee portion 12,000, employer 18,000. That is what we have put it onto the credit. So when you balance this account, again, you get a carried down brought forward. That is this amount, 30,000. Then this month, ETF 4,500 again accrued, payable. And EWF 3,000 payable. So the total other payable amount is 37,500. Last one, they're asking how much is a prepaid expense. Prepaid is a rent amount. We have paid 72,000 for 6 months, but only for 1 month we have to consider. The remaining 5 months value is prepayment. Thank you for watching the video. If you like, please click the like button. Comment on it, share it, and subscribe it.